No time wasted, no breaks needed. We got grand finals, baby. The Scuffed Invitational, about to wrap things up. Let's get it.
Let's go. All right, man. So the Diddy Kong did not come out until game three of their first set. He tried to set for off, and he didn't really work out in his favor. But now that the Diddy Kong has been, you know, on the screen, been a well-oiled machine here, hopefully this will get him some Ws. But I still think it's less about the matchup. It's just more about how Spargo's playing his advantage state 99.9% of the time. I just feel like whenever Tweek has to start being on the run, Spargo knows that, and he does not let up. Ooh.
Oh, doesn't get the banana slip on the platform, but Spargo with the downer. Great tech coming out from Tweek, but Spargo glowing blue. You're going to make a play happen here. Tries to send the blade beam all the way to the left, but Tweek avoiding it and using that double jump aggressively.
Oh, okay. Surprised with that. Well, not surprised. Very smash fast move on the shield, but I'm going to say, how does he go ahead and clean up his stock, though? I think he might need just a little extra damage here. Oh, but he can't he find it trying to land.
Definitely.
There it is. Spargo says, I'll attack in areas you don't expect me to be.
He's going to get it out there. Okay.
Doesn't
Fair
get
enough.
A punish, though. Has to recover on stage, but he still gets away with it. Tweek right now. Ooh,
nice
I like that preemptive up B. You see that a lot from Spargo to try to catch somebody. Feels like he doesn't really ever get punished all that hard for it.
There's no limit as well. Tweek can get one more hit, but it's not enough. Now, Spargo with the edge guard, the blade beam almost connecting on the barrels there. That would have been curtains. Spargo barely missing that edge guard opportunity. Katie,
oh, wow.
Is it enough? Yes, absolutely.
Might be version 4.1. Huh?
Dang.
Quick patch.
Already?
Quick patch.
He just got the 4.
Listen.
It is kind of wild to think of the fact that, you know, this was the main stage Grands.
Yeah.
And then this was Winners, and now it's Grands again. These two really kind of peeling out ahead of their competition across the board. I mean, Shuton definitely putting up a valiant effort, but, you know, the conversation was always Leo and who. And
right.
then for a while it was Tweek, and then it was Spargo, and now it's just like, well,
now
it is Easton.
I mean, really, at this point, it's just who.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? There's so many good contenders
Uh-oh.
For best in the world right now. You'd love to see it. You know, this game is far from solved, and all these players vying for their position, but consistency has definitely been favoring these two over the last couple of events.
It may not scoop under them, but for people who are still on that platform, that is a wide up air.
It's so meaty.
Yeah.
It lasts for so long. What are we going to do with this limit? Nothing. My blade beam eventually. Is that what we're going to do? We usually blade beam.
He
wanted it.
Yeah, he did. For
little
sure.
Off the mark there.
Just a tad bit. Watch these back airs. He's definitely fishing. Trying to exploit that. Spargo electing to be high, approaching with these aerials.
I can't believe that shield poke, unless he dropped it. But
yeah, maybe an attempted parry, but yeah, the air dodge going to get caught there.
I mean, this is actually just like insane how the way that this match is playing out, because it feels as though there's definitely stretches of time where both of them are in the driver's seat, but whenever Spargo's in the driver's seat, it just feels so much scarier for Tweek than whatever Tweek's in the driver's seat, at least from what I've been seeing so far. But we'll have to see how that develops. And if we get even more, Tweek dominance that he's been able to bring to the table in this matchup particularly before, and then on top of that, just throughout the tournament that we've seen, all day. But,
oh my goodness.
Wow. Yeah. Watch your neck.
Actually caught a fortune. Maybe the banana was down there to interrupt the potential follow-up.
Forward tilt not going to connect. Spargo able to use that up B right next to the ledge there. Dash attack coming through. Tweek barely surviving. Can you not get back there? The answer is no. So you get so many stocks in neutral or just cornering them.
Absolutely. And it's not even like a Steve straight hit, because there's so much more range that, like, if Steve goes for the straight hit, you still have this weird scramble after he lands. Cloud is just like, I'm still an advantage.
True.
Every time. I mean, I think that's probably the better part of this matchup for Cloud. Is that if Tweek is not in like 100% ready position to cover the disadvantage, I guess, Cloud's probably going to get back to neutral way quicker than Diddy would. Good stuff right there. Not spread too far apart.
Yeah, the fake out with the B reverse pop gun and canceling it.
Uh-oh.
On the ground into the up smash. But Tweek in the barrels does get the banana
slip. Oh, Lord.
Great conversion onto the platform.
Oh,
extends it.
Where are you going, son?
There's no double jump here. Can you get the forward tilt to end it? No, barely off the mark.
And I really like the fact that Spargo, instead of, he was right there at limit. He was like, no, I think I can make this. I don't believe that you're going to have the right edge guard.
Oh, tries to send the triple clap. Please, God. Please let this
one of these connect, please. Weak still looking for an answer for the second stock. Again, gets another scenario, but the limit is online. Spargo able to make it back on the stage, and look at the value. Just feels like Spargo's able. That should do the trick here. The banana just to stop the momentum. Is it enough? The portal does not connect.
And he got the banana. Come back.
The way this kid recovers, even like with no limit, it's like no problem.
Single stock Spargo has, right? Like, I feel like Spargo's living to that 130, 150 mark almost every time. So he has to work so hard for these KOs.
Honestly, I mean, okay, he's going to try to get right back into that middle stage. Even the man on the other side, this is really going to be the key to his offense almost every time. It's the banana opening things up. But he's got to get Spargo at a point where he can actually make that banana worth the effort of bringing it out every time, because Spargo's been, look at that. He's like actually double tapped that banana and got it out there super quickly.
Yeah, yeah, like, I'm just going to take this out of the equation here. Okay, once again, Tweak setting up the banana. Not going to be able to get the conversion, the pickup he wants, but the tech chase here does get one down to all these trades in favor of Tweak barely, but Spargo, he's hunted.
I think he gave that up because he literally was having a flashback of that happening last time.
Switch to Sephiroth.
Back to Sephiroth, yeah. And it's funny, this is a mirror image, right, of what we saw in the first game, first set, where it felt like we were wondering, you know, maybe if he goes straight Diddy, he wouldn't have thrown some games away, might be able to make it work. No, apparently the Diddy was no match for the Cloud either. Spargo just cutting through Tweak's entire roster.
And at least see if he can maybe get on the board. Not trying to get 3-0'd in Grand Finals. It was a very rough showing for him in Winners. So, trying to change that fortune for sure.
Oh, wow. Cross slash. Hey,
invincibility through the orb there.
To stop Light from dashing in and just doing Light stuff, it's just like trying to charge at him. And he actually lost the stock first. Sephiroth is just so light, tying to the back air.
And now no wing.
Trying to figure out what he can do here. I mean, you saw him actually drop that up tilt, which should be able to take it, the counter drop. But it's weird that, like, I feel like that type of gameplay has not really developed much more after, I guess, the Smash 4 Bayonetta, where it's like, yeah, definitely don't swing at me because I'm going to, you know, I'm going to wish time and then get a full combo.
Right.
But, like, we still have some very strong counters in this game, and Scintilla is definitely one of them. So, you know, it's one. I feel like it's actually one of the better counters for the sole fact that it'll still have a hitbox even if it doesn't counter.
Yeah.
And it just doesn't seem like Tweak likes to use it too often, but he's doing a better job this time around of using it. Okay, this could be it, right? That's exactly what I'm talking about. Look where he's at.
Gets the launch, the forward tilt.
He doesn't normally get that launch either. Remember, in their first set in Winners Finals, he could not get that down tilt.
Tweak can't really commit to too much hitboxes here. Since you are Sephiroth, just trying to move, trying to wait for Spargo to make some kind of action here, but now Spargo back on the stage. The wing is here for Tweak, though.
Oh, that could have been curtains if he didn't forward air.
We'll take that. Okay.
Okay, it's the punish, dash grab, the tech chase. Not going to be able to go all the way to the left there, but Tweak holding center stage and really punishing Spargo, going for that left platform.
Yeah, he's stopping him from landing, which is exactly what Spargo likes to do. And there, up smash in the wrong direction, gonna go for the chop. He's able to survive.
But I mean, really, just really good cross up right there from Tweak. I mean, not really an option to see him go for too often, to go for the upbeat angle down like that. But he crossed the shield, so therefore he was behind Spargo, was not gonna get up smash. But it's still scary on both sides. I think, you know, there is a lot of kill power behind Seth, which is not, it's not something he just throws out. So at least you can, don't have to worry about that. The limit's gone. Oh, hold that. Wow. He's counting. He's 3 for 3.
This is another thing that Tweak.
Oh, man. I thought he actually got that that potential pivot grab or something like that. But no, drop anything up air. That move looks beautiful anytime it hits.
It does.
It's a gorgeous move.
It really is. Finesse.
Yeah, but we've seen this before. Spargo at very high percent where Tweak can't really seal it out. And then Spargo with the rage or just getting a great string of situations here. We've seen Spargo in that advantage state. You can't count him out just yet.
Especially with how frustrated Tweak was at the end of the last game. You can see it crumbling here.
Still not the strong hit of the up air.
Oh, no.
And the limit zone. Okay, man, if he had a tech, then he was getting finished
in
touch.
Oh, no. Oh, man. The up air into the upbeat with the limit wasn't enough to connect.
He neutral aired instead of potential up air.
202, by the way.
Okay, there finally. 216%.
Up until this point, getting that wing online, much needed. That's gonna be a back air.
He really got that day one advice. You know, like, you get off like the main stage off of game five, and like the one thing you get wrong at the end, there's like that 1-2-2 where it's like, why didn't you just counter?
Oh, 157 here. Spargo, there's no fear. He just rammed right in and did dash tech. And I think that's the thing. Sephiroth looks scary, but the way you beat him is you just hit him. You see it there. Tweak is like trying to set up and look big. right? He's trying to sit there and make you afraid of him, and Spargo's just like, no, land with fair.
Oh, man, and yeah, Tweak really, again, working so hard for these stocks, 184%.
Nice.
And the reverse up tilt is going to KO Sevra off the top.
202 again. And all he can do is snap his fingers. Like, that's just, yeah. Like, if somebody's on you, that's the best shot you have. Finally, forward air, 222.
And see, Sephiroth not even being able to, like, frame trap, right? Most characters can catch an air dodge to the ground, mash another button, but Tweak trying to do that, not going to work. Does get the grab, tries to get the jump. No, Spargo's swinging, and the air dodge doesn't get caught with the limit option.
Yeah, that could have gone worse, I think. But
yeah, oh, yeah.
Yeah, he just got the grab instead, a little bit safer.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, that would have. Look, if he jumped off the ledge the wrong way, that might have been something.
But oh, that, is that it?
That would have been insane early stock right there. Oh, he tried the counter, but he was too low.
Yeah, he
got under him, yeah.
Yeah, Nair into wing backer is actually one of the few confirms that Sephiroth can go ahead and go for that does KO quite early here.
Uh-oh. Oh, man, that was. That was almost like when the Pyra Myth or the Mithra side B back in. The Tweak, though, still got the good amount of damage here on to Spargo, but he has to find this stock before this gets too scary, and we're already halfway there.
Now, how high of a percent will Spargo get this stock? That's the big question here, or at least how little damage can Tweak take, right? 42% already on the board here. Spargo racking up on Tweak, and even more, tries to get the reverse RP. Okay, we're getting crazy.
Oh, that down tilt was actually sick.
Ooh. Speaking of, okay, Wing's back on deck, but I mean, the limit is also right there. Nice!
Finally, okay. Has Wing, this is his saving grace.
Yeah, but like, how long will he be able to keep it?
So,
we have to find out. Okay, the up air is going to get parried, but no hard punish from.
He's getting so much mileage,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, he is.
Okay, got it.
Ooh,
forces
good
the
catch.
Limit here.
This is nuts.
Oh my god, this is so much damage for Tweak.
He might actually be able to keep this wing the entire stock.
Down tilt, no. Angle
versus limit. Oh no!
It poked. Wow, that's tough.
And that's such like a simple thing that you would know in most circumstances, but I think he was feeling himself with the wing for so long that he didn't consider that.
As a man's gonna get back on stage, jumping over Seth. Oh my god, get sent.
Damn,
that dash attack was it right there. And there is our champion of the Scuf Invitational, Spargo, taking two tournaments in a row.
You gotta love Spargo in that situation too, just so well composed after the W as well.
It just beautifully played all the way through, and you could see the difference in Cloud and Sephiroth, because it felt like Spargo just consistently, no fear in Sephiroth. You know, he wasn't afraid of Sephiroth just sort of keeping that space and throwing out these hitboxes. He just dash attacked through. He kept bursting through. He kept forward airing through. And because of that,